One of the greatest mysteries of creation or the universe as we know it at the moment is the fact that not everything is fully formed and yet everything is fully formed. It's just like it's a paradox. What I'm talking about here is the principle of seeds. There's a lot that can be done, and a lot that can be done is already available in terms of seeds. The mango tree has a seed, and inside of the seed you plant it and you get very many other mango trees, and those mango trees have seeds and so on, and it just goes on and on. If you remove the principle of seeds from creation or from the universe, then you have what we call death. Naturally, eventually, nothing else happens. But we have seeds in different forms, seeds in different aspects. And if we are going to develop in life, then we're going to look at this in terms of potential. And potential is one of the things that we're discussing in these episodes. And we want to find out what exactly can you do in order to cultivate, to deploy the potential that you do have. Stay tuned.
Welcome to the Life Signatures Podcast with Lawrence Namale. Lawrence is a life coach, author, and keynote speaker who loves to tackle different topics on purpose, productivity, and resilience. His mission in life is to awaken all your boundless possibilities available in you. Life Signatures Podcast is dedicated to bring to reality every single person who knows that deep down in their gut, there's got to be more to life than this. And now, here is your host, Lawrence Namale.
So the seeds in life, they speak about possibility, they speak about potential, but at the same time, those very seeds are in what we call the dormant state. They are in a latent state. In other words, if you pick a mango seed and you don't put it anywhere, just put it on top of a concrete floor, I mean, it can stay there forever with that potential and might even die at the end of the day. One of the most interesting things about seeds is that they have some kind of longevity. They can stay for quite a while, but then you can mess up with the seeds. But unless the seed is put into the conducive environment that it was designed to optimally operate in, that seed is not going to grow. It is not going to mature. And that's exactly what happens with the human being and their potential. That this potential is seldom put in a conducive environment where it's able to grow. And at the end of the day, by the way, I don't even think we go long enough to identify that potential. I mean, we have, like I've said in the previous episodes, we have systems where we've dedicated ourselves into hammering things into the life of people instead of creating systems that are going to draw out things from people, because people come with potential, people come with possibilities, people come with seeds that are inside of them, seeds that can help them to grow, seeds that can help them to fulfill their God-given purpose. And the problem is that we are doing the opposite. Instead of drawing out these things out of them, drawing out the potential, cultivating the potential, increasing the potential, increasing the size of the exposure of the potential, putting the potential in the most conducive environment, we are doing the opposite. We are oblivious of the potential, and the things that we are cramming into people's lives might not necessarily be things to do with their potential. We just want them to be uniform. We want them to be up to a particular standard of life, so that they can be able to operate, we can be comfortable that yes, they went through this standard and they can say like this, they can do like this, they can think like this, and that's just about it. But in the process, the potential is curtailed. I saw a very interesting headline yesterday that there's a Kenyan pilot who had been flying people for 8 good years with a fake academic paper in high school. Now, the fake academic paper is not even the issue. The issue is that the guy has actually been successfully flying people. No crashes, no nothing. But I'm just mixing myself up. Let me not go into that angle. We are discussing what are some of the things that we can be able to do in order for us to cultivate the potential that we do have. I think we've said that one of the easiest things you need to do is to take action. And we said yesterday that we have no problem taking action. I mean, we are the most active people on the face of the earth. We wake up in the morning and we are running helter-skelter. We've got to pay bills, we've got to put food on the table, we've got to beat the traffic and so on. And we faithfully do this for years on end, for decades on end. We've been taking action. The question is, what kind of action are we taking? We need to take action that cultivates our potential, action that excavates our potential, action that deploys our potential. It is possible to take very many types of action and do very many types of activity that have no inkling on the potential that we do have. That's why you find guys who are gifted writers not writing, gifted artists not doing their art, gifted poets not doing poetry. You find guys who can be able to paint are working in some kind of job somewhere. There's nothing wrong with making money and paying bills, but why would God put potential inside of you if you're not cultivating it? What is the purpose of that? So the first thing that we said we need to do is to analyze our lives, to review our lives on an occasional basis, maybe at the end of the week, at the end of the month. The problem with us is that we do this in a split second at the beginning of every year. And even at the beginning of every year, we realize how much we need to do, how far we need to go. Just in that split second of thinking and making resolutions, where do you think those resolutions come from? They come from the voice of potential speaking to us that this is a possibility, that's a possibility, you could do this, you could do that. And that's why reviews are important. The more we do reviews, the more we are on track in listening to the voice of potential and actually exploiting it. Because we've said we have no problem taking action. The question is, what kind of action are we taking? So the kind of action that is potent, loaded, that is going to speak to our potential, going to cultivate our potential, is the action that has been reviewed, action that has been analyzed, action that has, you know, been done through introspection. So the results that we get from that introspection give us the kind of action points that we need to have in our lives. But today I want us to discuss something that is totally important. Because this is one of the ways that we can be able to cultivate our potential. And it's simply this. You need to listen to feedback that has come from other people. You know why? Because there's this thing called familiarity breeds contempt. In other words, things that come naturally to you, easily to you, you feel like it is the same for other people. In fact, you don't understand why. I never forget, there's a time I was in a church choir and they were auditioning us. Of course, they auditioned us and they put us in different kind of voices that we were able to sing. And I remember the kind of voice I was supposed to sing. And then there was a particular Sunday, the choir leader, for some reason, switched the voices and said that, you know, I'm not supposed to sing a mid, I'm supposed to sing a high. And as much as I tried to sing the high, I couldn't hit those notes. And then there was this guy who was such a natural guy. He came and said, you know, this is how you do it. You just... And then he opened his mouth and hit a high. For him, it's no big deal to sing that high. It's no big deal. It comes naturally to him. He feels like it's the simplest thing there ever was. And to me, it's rocket science. It's brain surgery. You're frustrating me here. You're killing me here. And that's the problem. That's why you need to listen to feedback from other people. Because as you go around your life, as you go doing life, people notice things that they don't see in themselves, in you. And the question is that how involved or how intense are you in following through those things that people are telling you, that feedback that people are giving you about your life on specific issues, specific details? They will tell you, Lawrence, you're such a good speaker. Lawrence, you're such a good writer. And woe to me if I get that kind of feedback and I don't use that feedback, because every time they see something unique in you, it is also the voice of potential speaking up through them, telling you that there is something here, there is something here, there is content here. You know, there is something that is, why would they notice it? Because it's different, it's standing out. The problem is that if you're alone, he doesn't stand out because it's unnatural. Just like that guy who opens his mouth and hits a high, it's no big deal for him. Miles Monroe said that most of us have never met ourselves. We are afraid of ourselves. The real self is the one they taught you to suppress. And even if they taught you to suppress, as you keep doing the real you, someone else sees that thing. So it turns out that feedback from other people can give you incredible insight on what your potential is, and specifically what you need to focus on in order to maximize it. It turns out that way. I talked about critics in some kind of episode back then, and maybe I'm going to revisit it, but these guys can be toxic. I mean, I'm telling you, they can be the biggest line of people you ever saw on this earth is critics. Every time someone steps up and does something that has never been done before, critics will come. And you know, one of the most interesting things about critics is that they have never done that which they're criticizing. 100% of critics, most of them never have done something that they are criticizing. But let me tell you, someone who has done something and they see you trying to do the same, they will not critique you. They will not criticize you. They will mentor you. They will, you know, give you a thumbs up and so on and so forth. However, there is a time to listen. There's a time, you know, to weigh this criticism and take feedback from people. At times, not just critics. For the most part, you could never thank people enough for giving you this feedback. And that feedback is critical in realizing what your potential is. It is fodder for doing better. My greatest revivals have always been when someone pulled me aside and told me, "You messed here. I mean, you should think better, you should do better." My heart has always struck some conviction in it, and I felt sorry for myself, and I promised myself that I'm gonna do better. And in the areas where I got feedback from people, those areas I've always watched and I've always done better. So for a business case, for example, the worst thing that could ever happen is when a dissatisfied customer comes in and they don't say nothing, they don't give you feedback, they just go with their mouth shut. You'll never improve. But when someone gives you feedback, my friend, they have noticed something you've taken for granted. And the thing that people take for granted for the most part, due to the way we've been raised up, due to the status quo, due to the system that we've set up, the thing that people are always oblivious of and taking for granted is potential, for the most part. So rarely when someone rises up and gives you feedback, positively or negatively, and tell you, "I saw how you spoke. That was something else. There's something about you and speaking. There's something about you and writing. There's something about you and numbers. There's something about you and leadership. There's just something about you with the way you work with babies and the way you work with young people. There's just something about you, the way you work with graphics and so on. There's just something about you, the way you work with words." That's feedback, that's potential speaking in the voice of other people, and we need to take heed and we need to listen to it. So if you wanted to rise up the ante in terms of your potential, put a keen ear on what people are saying specifically about you. How many times have people called you genius? How many times have people called you unique in a particular area? The question is, that's not just the issue. The issue is, have you taken steps to cultivate even further and even deeper in those particular areas? If not, your potential is being ignored, being taken for granted, staying dormant and latent. And that's a disservice to yourself and to humanity. Tomorrow we'll talk about something else, but until then, think about that and bye-bye. A special shout out to my mentor, Jeffrey Howard of Visionary Business University. found at mastermindmentor.com, who has graciously provided me with the soundtrack and the introductory track to this podcast. Thank you, Jeff.
Thank you for listening to Life Signatures Radio. If you enjoyed today's show, subscribe to Life Signatures Radio on iTunes, Stitcher, or visit our website at lifesignatures.libsyn.com. Life Signatures Radio, fresh, clean, and inspiring.